Children, in our previous class, we have completed lesson 3, Meena's letter from textbook. Now, let us start lesson 3 from activity book. See here, children, Meena's letter. Read and understand. Let us read this letter, children. Here again, they have given one letter. This letter is written by Vidya to her friend. See here, they have noted here the date and the letter is Dear Gauri, I'm having a great time at my grandfather's house. It is near Mysore, which is a very beautiful city in Karnataka. Mysore is famous for its tourist spots. The first place I visited with grandfather was the Mysore Palace. It is really big and beautiful. The whole palace is lit up and glitters like gold during Dashara and the national festivals. We visited the Vrindavan Gardens after seeing the palace. The Mysore Zoo too is an exciting place. It has many kinds of animals. It was thrilled to see giraffes, elephants and rhinos. We also visited the Chamundi Hills. 1,000 steps lead to the hills. The city looks beautiful from the top of the hills. I wish you were here with me. Your loving friend, Vidya. Who wrote this letter, children? Vidya. She wrote about her trip to grandfather's house where it is Mysore. And she went first of all Mysore Palace. After that, they visited Vrindavan Gardens. After visiting Vrindavan Gardens, they went to Mysore Zoo. And also she told that the city looks beautiful from the top of the hills. Who wrote this letter, children? Vidya. To whom she wrote? To her friend. Okay. Now, let us get into the exercises from this read and understand passage. Okay. In this exercise, we should take the correct answers from the options. Let us check the first one. This letter was written by whom, children? Of course, Vidya. So we have to tick C. And the second one, this letter is mainly about Mysore Palace, Vidya's trip to Mysore, or Vidya and Gauri's friendship. Tell me, children. Vidya's trip to Mysore. So we have to tick option B. And let us check the third one. The Mysore Palace is special because it is big and beautiful, or it is full of animals, or it has 1,000 steps. Tell me, children. Of course, it is big and beautiful. And the fourth one is, the second place that Vidya visited in Mysore was the Vrindavan Gardens, Mysore Zoo, Chamundi Hills. Tell me, children. I already explained you where she has visited in the second. Yes. Of course, Vrindavan Gardens. So, we have to tick option A. Now, let us get into our next exercise. In this exercise, children, we should fill in the blanks with the correct words from the brackets. They have given two words here. We should fill in these blanks. See here, I can dash someone singing. Dash to the bird singing. Here, we should fill with these two words. But, which word is suitable, we have to find out. Here, and listen. What are the differences between these two, children? See, we use here for sounds that come to our ears without us necessarily trying to hear them. For example, they heard a strange noise in the middle of the night. Now, let us know about listen. Listen is used to describe paying attention to sounds that are going on. So, easily we can write here, I can dare someone singing. Listen or hear, children? Any guess? Of course, hear. I can hear someone singing. And hear the remaining part because see, listen to the birds singing. So it is paying attention to listen someone. So we have to write here, listen. Okay, let us check the next one, children. Breathe, smell. And the blanks are dash in the fresh air, These lilies die so sweet. This is easily you can say, but let me explain what are the differences between breathe and smell. Before filling these blanks, let us know about the meaning of breathe. Breathe means what, children? The air taken into or expelled from the lungs. For example, see, inhalation, exhalation will be happen from the lungs, right? That is called breathe. For example, I was gasping for breath. Now let us know about smell. Here the word smell means, see, the faculty of or power of perceiving odors or sense by means of the organs in the nose. For example, I think I can smell something burning. I think I can smell the fragrance of flowers. These are the examples. Now, easily you can say here what you can fill in the blanks here. Dash in the fresh air. Breathe in the fresh air. Breathe in the fresh air. And these lilies, dash so sweet. Yes, of course. Smell. These lilies smell so sweet. Yes or no? Now, let us check the third one. Eat, chew. See here, children, again we have to know the perfect meaning of these words, eat and chew. See here, the guava is a hard fruit. Dash it properly. Now, let us know about what is the meaning of eat and chew. Here the word eat means, children, you will put some food in your mouth and you will chew it and you will swallow it. Means, for example, he was eating a hot dog. Yes or no? What is the meaning of chew? After eating the food, what you will do with your teeth? You will chew it. Yes or no? See here, what we have to fill here? The guava is a hard fruit. Dash it properly. Chew it properly. And the next blank is dash this delicious cake. Of course, eat this delicious cake. So let us fill the word with eat. And the next one is look, see. You should know what are the differences between look and see. After knowing the meaning only, you can fill the words here in the blanks. Now let us know the meaning of look and see. Here, look means, children, an act of directing one's gaze in order to see someone or something. For example, let me get a closer look. Or, I look at tennis differently from some coaches. Or, people were looking at him. Now, let us know about see. Here the word see means perceive with the eyes, discern visually. For example, in the distance, she could see the blue sea. Now, let us check the blanks here, children. Dash at those beautiful mountains. And did you dash the moon rise? Tell me, children, which verse to be filled here? Here, we have to fill with look. See, now let us read full sentence here. Look at those beautiful mountains. Here, did you see the moon rise? Let us fill the word with see. Okay. Now, let us get into our next exercise. See here. Write the words from the box in the correct clouds. See, they have given some words here. Alone, duo, triple, double, single, pair, four, trio, mono. We have to write these words in the particular cloud boxes. Let us check the clouds here. 1, 2, more than 2. So, let us check the first one, alone. Alone means what, children? Having no one else present. Means she was alone that evening. So, it will come to this cloud. So, let us write here, alone in the one cloud. Our next word is duo. What is the meaning of duo, children? In the lesson also, we came to know that they have called themselves what? Meena duo. Here, how many Meenas were there? 2. So, duo. And the perfect meaning is, see, A pair of people or pair of things, especially in music or in friends or in entertainment. For example, the comedy duo Laurel and Hardy. Two duos for violin and viola. Okay, so here duo means two. Let us write here duo. Only two. So we are writing this word in two cloud. And more than two here we have to note. Here see triple. Triple means the number three. So we have to write here triple. Triple means three. More than two we have to note here. And double. Double means two. So we have to write here double. Single. Single means only one. So let us write here the word single in the one cloud. Pair. Pair means two. So we have to write here pair. And after that four. It is number four. So more than two we have to note here, right? Let us note down here four. And here trio. Trio means three. So let us write here which is more than two. And here mono. Mono means single. The perfect meaning of mono is one or alone or to be single. So we have noted mono here. Finally, we have completed exercise C and let us get into spell write. Children, in this exercise, we have to fill in the blanks with TCH or CH to complete the words. See, they have given some blanks here to fill with these two letters. See here, we sat on a patch of grass and ate our lunch. So, here we have to fill with TCH and here CH. See, now it became a perfect sentence. We sat on a patch of grass and ate our lunch. After completing this sentence, we have to keep full stop. Let us check the second one. Then we dash our dash play a cricket dash. See, here we watched our teachers play a cricket match. So here TCH, watched our teachers. So again here CH, here match. So TCH. After completing this sentence, what we have to do? We have to keep full stop. See, then we watched our teachers play a cricket match. And the third one is we dash our class dash, then she scored a six. See, we cheered our class teacher when she scored a six. So here CH, cheered, and here again CH, teacher. Now it became a meaningful sentence. And the fourth one is when she was fielding, she missed a catch. Again here we have to fill with catch, TCH. After finishing this sentence, we have to keep full stop. And the next one is, however, later she dash and stopped the ball, saving three runs. What is here? Chased. So we have to use here CH. So children, in this exercise, we have completed this fill in the blanks. Now let us get into the next exercise. Children, our next exercise is understand grammar. Here, Jyoti and her friends do many things every day. Use the words in the box to write five sentences about what they do. Here, they have given few words here. Play, read, write, run, talk. See here, children, we should use simple present and present continuous tense for these understand grammar exercises. For example, see here, children, Jyoti and her friends play in the park. Okay, in the same manner, we have to fill the next four also. See here, the best example is here they have given Jyoti and her friends play in the park. So here the word they have used play. And the next word is read. What is the next word, children? Read. They read stories to each other. So let us fill the sentence here. They read stories each other. They read stories each other. After completing sentence, what we have to keep? Full stop. In the same manner, you have to fill the remaining three also. Now, let us check the next exercise here. Write about five things that happen regularly or always. For example, the earth goes around the sun. In the same manner, you have to write remaining also. And our next exercise is, look at the picture and write a sentence about each one is doing. See here, Mistress Das is playing cricket, right? So, let us write the sentence here, playing cricket. Okay, we have completed successfully this sentence. In the same manner, you have to write the remaining. See here, children, Geeta. Geeta is, what she is doing? Tell me, children, what she is doing? Geeta is talking on the phone. And here, Susie. Susie is shivering with cold. Here, duck. The duck is pulling at the man's trousers. And here, Aslam. Aslam is reading a book. In the same manner, you have to fill the remaining sentences also. Children, our next exercise is write well. Children, your next task is write well. In this write well, you have to write a letter. See here, you have found the name and address of a student in Malaysia in your school magazine. Write a letter to her, asking her to be your friend. So, you have to write a letter. I'll show you the pattern how to write. Children, see the pattern here. First of all, you have to note down the date and you have to mention here, dear Lily, and what you are thinking about her and how you will ask to be your friend. Everything, you have to write the sentences over here. After finishing your letter, you will come to here. The conclusion is, your friend means who is Lily's friend? You only. So, you have to note down your name here. Okay, children, try to write the letter properly without making any mistakes and check the sentences before you write there. And children, in this class, we have completed our activity book part. And in our next class, let us start chapter 3 from the grammar book. Okay, children, until that, you complete these three exercises. Thank you.